There is always a question of what is more important, IQ or EQ. People always misunderstand that intelligence or IQ is the most important thing in life to succeed. But they're clearly wrong, because emotional quotient or your empathy that you have towards other people in life is very key for you to succeed. And I'm going to tell it to you in a very, very simple story that happened to me a few years back. I was in Amsterdam and it was during lunchtime. I was walking through a very, very busy street and I was trying to figure out where to go and have lunch. I went from one restaurant to another, to the next bistro and to another, and I see that there's a lot of crowd everywhere. I was totally getting discouraged. But then finally I found a place where it was relatively less crowded. So I went in there and I ordered for a pasta, regular pasta, and it looked like a pretty good restaurant. And when the pasta came, it was already about like half an hour. They took so much time to give me the order. And by the time it came, I tasted it and it was really bad. I mean, it was not even edible. When I ate it and I was like, I called the waiter and I told him, I didn't think so, this is the right kind of stuff, you got it here. And this guy comes back and tells me, I cannot do anything about it. This is a straightforward preparation and this is a standard dish. And I thought that these guys don't get it, you know, and I'm trying to tell this guy a feedback and he's not even taking it. So I was very frustrated, especially I was hungry and I had walked all around the city. And all I wanted to have was one good pasta, but I couldn't get it. With a lot of frustration, I just paid the money to this guy and then I walked out of the restaurant. I didn't even eat the pasta. And I come out of the restaurant and I was very, very upset. And I looked at this small bistro that was there just next to this restaurant. And it was jam-packed. I could see a line coming out and people are standing out and stuff. And I didn't know whether I should go there and should I go there and approach them or not. Should I stand in the queue or not? I didn't know. But then I kind of mustered the courage and I went inside and I stood in the queue. And within a matter of a minute, a young waitress, she came and she greeted me and she told, what would you like to have? Let's catch up some speed. In the time you're, you know, in the queue, I'm going to look at, you know, how I can help you get your meal as soon as possible. And I was delighted. I was so happy because here I was really, really dreading to stand on the queue, and she comes up and she's thinking about how do I optimize the whole time there. So I gave the order and she asked me, okay, it looks like, you know, what do you like to eat? And she suggested different cuisines and stuff. What are my tastes? So she was really chatty, but she understood what I wanted. And in a matter of 15 minutes, I got the table. And by the time I went and sat at the table, the waitress comes and, you know, keeps the pasta in front of me. Again, I had ordered another pasta. So she comes and keeps the pasta in front of me. And I was delighted. I told her that you guys are awesome because you guys optimized it so well that I just sat and you're getting me the meal. She laughed and she said, you give me the compliment when you taste it. If you like that, you know, the dish, I'm going to be extremely happy. So I tasted it and it was delicious. And it was amazing. I called the chef and the chef was there and congratulated the chef on the amazing experience these guys gave me. That was the whole point. Today, when I look back, this is one of the most amazing meals I've ever had in my life. I still remember it. And it is only possible because of the amazing customer experience that these guys created. It was an experience. The queue, the way she spoke, the way these people got the whole pasta when I just about to was sitting, the way I was very, very hungry that day, and the taste itself and the chef, the whole thing was a great experience. And everything came back to one thing. It was empathy, because they understood pain points of the customers. They were proactive enough to go and solve the pain points, and then they created a wow experience with great quality food. So the bottom line is, empathy helps you to understand people and create a wow experience for them, just like the second restaurant. Compare them to the first restaurant who did not understand their customers, who couldn't solve their problem and made everybody's life miserable. So, what you need to decide is in life, who do you want to become? The restaurant number one, which did not have any empathy towards others. Restaurant number two, who had empathy, who proactively solved their problems and succeeded. It's your call.